Good morning, student. Today I am going to start the chapter that is written by Sudha Murthy. Sudha Murthy began her professional career as a computer scientist and engineer. She got the Best Teacher Award in 1995 from Rotary Club Bangalore. She is best known for the social work and her contribution to literature in Kannada and English. Children, now I am going to start one of her interesting story that is given in your English reader book, chapter number 16, China Silk. First, I am going to explain the summary of this chapter. So, listen carefully. I hope you will enjoy the chapter. So, there lived a poor girl in village in China. One day the emperor saw her walking in the field and immediately fell in love with her. The girl was subsequently married to him and taken to the palace. But she was unhappy as she had grown up in wide open space and was now confined to a palace. Why girl was unhappy? Because in her village she is playing, dancing, moving here and there, but here she is caught in a palace. That's why the emperor tried his best to make her happy, but nothing helped. One afternoon the empress was sitting in her garden when she saw some threads peeping out from a cocoon that had fallen into hot water. All her servants got to work and gathered a fair amount of yarn from the cocoons. The empress then wove the first piece of cloth using that thread. This was silk, the best and brightest from the from of cloth, which was the supplied all across the globe through the silk route. The Chinese kept this knowledge as a secret, but many years later a clever princess hid some cocoons in her elaborate hairdo and took them with her to her husband's house. That's how the knowledge of how to make the silk left China. Children, look how interesting that story is. The Chinese kept their knowledge secret, but one princess take some cocoons in her hairdo and spread in whole world making of silk. So today you will read the chapter one or two time. That is homework for you. And tomorrow I will start the chapter from your textbook. Thank you.